Hello and welcome to another SugarFX tutorial. Our technical support team receives many questions, and one of them is that many users just want to add burned-in subtitles to an existing movie. So what is the best way to do that in Final Cut Pro X? The answer is pretty simple, and I will try to show the process in this example. Most of the movies that come straight from a camera or from other sources usually have the timecode when it was recorded or some sort of timecode data. As you can see, I have Final Cut Pro X open and I grabbed one of these movies from the hard drive and placed it in a new timeline. I started adding a few markers to create the subtitles, but I am not finished with them yet. First, click on the movie and head over to the Properties and select the Info tab. As you can see, this movie has a start time code of 4 hours, 36 minutes and 2 seconds, 18 frames. This time code data will be important in just a few moments. I am going to continue adding the last two markers that I need to finish the subtitles for this piece. Move the timeline to the location where I want the next marker, and press the letter M in my keyboard. This creates a marker. I press the letter M again to edit the contents of the marker, and I will go ahead and type the subtitle text. If I want to control the duration of this subtitle, then I should enable the chapter marker instead of the standard marker. Press down to accept, and adjust the duration by moving the orange round pin of the marker. Finally, I move to where my last subtitle should be and press M again to create a marker, and press M again to edit its contents. I will use a standard marker this time and go ahead and type the subtitle text and press the Done button to accept. Now that I have finished placing the subtitles markers, it is time to export the XML file. I will go to the File menu and select Export XML. And I will save it to the desktop. Next, go to the title browser and scroll down to the subtitles category and use the subtitles element and place it along the top of the video with the same duration as the clip. Select the subtitles element in the timeline and click the Edit Text button that shows up on the screen. You can select all of the text and press Delete in your keyboard to get rid of the built-in sample text, and then click on the Import from File button to import the XML we just saved. Select it and press the Import button. Finally, press OK to accept the file and close the text editor. At this moment, you would expect to see the subtitles. However, you need to see the information in the window to understand what may be happening if the subtitles do not show up. The plugin is telling us that there are some subtitles decoded, but the next subtitle will appear at the 4 hours, 36 minutes and 2 seconds and 43 one-hundredths of a second. This means that the XML file saved the marker data with the timecode of the clip and not the timeline, and we need to compensate for that. So, with the subtitles element selected in the timeline, go to the inspector window and make sure you are in the title tab to see its parameters. Scroll down until you see the time offset parameter and enable the timecode option. In here, you have to type the actual starting timecode of the clip that we checked earlier. That was 4 hours, 36 minutes, and 2 seconds, 18 frames. So I need to type 04360218 separated by a period. Now the subtitles should display correctly and match the marker location of each subtitle. Remember to click the Info button to disable the on-screen information before you render. Well, we hope this tutorial was helpful, and we'll see you again in another SugarFX tutorial.